Hello everyone, welcome to In 5 Minutes. Today we are going to learn about discrete Fourier transform. Discrete Fourier transform is a computer-based frequency domain analysis. It is a way of analyzing things. There are many applications based on discrete Fourier transform. They are spectral analysis, filtering, convolution, compression of JPEG images. It analyzes the time domain signal in order to extract the frequency domain information, like the frequency domain components. So we may understand by looking at these two signals. This is a general signal given by x of n, and this is a DFT function. Can be a sine wave or a cosine wave. Basically, the DFT function compares these two signals, and there is a block called of correlation. Correlation is a measure of similarity between these two signals. This will basically generate a value that is a complex number, for example, 2.4 plus 1.6j. We may see how discrete Fourier transform is performed. Let us first understand the basic definition of discrete Fourier transform. Let x of n be a discrete time signal of length L, and x of k represent the DFT of n. Now we write the endpoint DFT as x of k is equal to summation n is equal to 0 ranging to n minus 1 x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi k n by capital N, where k ranges from 0, 1, 2 to n minus 1. The term x of k obtained after the operation of DFT is a sequence consisting of complex numbers. They can be of similar type of 1 plus j 4, 2 minus j3, etc. The magnitude and the phase of each sample can be computed and listed as magnitude sequence and phase sequence. Similarly, we can obtain inverse DFT of the sequence x of k. So the inverse DFT is defined as x of n is equal to 1 by n summation k is equal to 0 n minus 1 x of k e raised to j 2 pi k n by n, where n ranges from 0 to n minus 1. Similarly, DFT and inverse DFT can be represented as pairs, like x of n, when discrete Fourier transform is applied, is converted to the sequence of x of k. And similarly, when inverse discrete Fourier transform is applied to x of k, it becomes x of n. The term x of k is a discrete function of frequency of discrete time signal, and so it is called as discrete frequency spectrum. So the x of k is a complex valued function that can be represented as x of real part of k plus x of imaginary part of k. So basically these two terms are useful for plotting magnitude and phase spectrum. So the magnitude spectrum can be generated as x of k square is equal to root of x of r of k the whole square, that is a real part, plus x of I of k the whole square. So we can plot the magnitude spectrum based on this term. Similarly, for phase spectrum, we can have angle x of k is equal to tan inverse of imaginary part of x of k upon real part of x of k. So these are the basic terms needed to understand and perform discrete Fourier transform. So in further videos, we are going to solve the sums based on discrete Fourier transform using these formulas. Thank you.